Hi everyone, I'm back with another video, and in today's video, we'll be going some things so that of course you can increase your credit income without paying anything. Now of course, before we start, go on ahead, smash the like button so that the video will be recommended to other players of the game and non-players of the game, hopefully. And of course, subscribe to the channel and turn on the notification so you will not miss an upload or stream from my channel. Without further ado, let's go jump straight
and
into
so here goes. Now, as discussed or mentioned at the start of the video, we will be going over some tips on how you can earn credits, okay? Just to let you guys know, and most of you have seen on my stream that, you know, like, I start my stream with, like, I don't know, 800 to, like, 10,000 credits, and then ending my stream with, like, 170 to 150,000 credits, or even more, okay? With just, what, 3, 4, 5 battles, sometimes even 7 battles or so. And let me just share you the secret to that, okay? Now, again, I would just like to point things out here. We'll go over this one by one. Now, first of all, I would just like to discuss more about PvP. Okay, now, PvP does give out credits, and of course, if you haven't played a single battle within the day, you have the first daily, first victory bonus, okay? That's like 10,800. And you also need to have premium, guys. Okay, this guy right here, premium, the star right here, this is very important as this allows you to, for you to see your enemy, okay, and so on. Plus, it does give 1.5 times for premium status, okay? So just to let you guys know about that, that's very important. Now, what I do recommend is for you to go 2v2 instead of PvP. We'll go more on that later on, okay, as to why I do recommend 2v2 instead of PvP, okay? Now, let's go on to the next topic, okay, which will be the AI. Okay, now the AI, as you guys can see right here, it does have a cost of 1,100 and 9,682 for the reward. Now guys, keep in mind that this does not include your activity bonus and the time spent bonus for doing the AI. And of course, what I meant by you doing this AI or skirmish right here is for you to do this without using any boost. Now, particularly, if I do an AI battle right now, I'll get like around 10,000 to 12,000 credits. That's after the result with the other multipliers kicking in and, of course, boosting my reward. Okay, what do I mean by kickers and multipliers? Those are like the activity, time spent, and so on. Okay, now if you do this 3 times, that's a clean 30,000 credits already. Okay, just to let you guys know about that. Now, if you're going for tournament, that is also very, very good. Okay, as tournaments, tournament rewards are very, very cool. As you guys can see, 38,847, and this does not include the multipliers for the new reward system like activity, stronger opponent, and time spent, as well as so on and so forth, okay? But regularly, if, you know, just to give you guys a tip, if I were going to play my first victory, I'll go over tournament, okay? Why? Why is that? Okay, now the answer is that, firstly, is that it gives you 10,800 first victory bonus, okay? And then you'll get like around 50 and above 1,000 credits, okay? The most I got for the tournament are like 76 to 77,000 credits, okay? With the first daily victory bonus, okay? Just to let you guys know about that. Now, for PvP, going back here on PvP, we do have PvP, start battle right here, 2v2, and of course, 3v3, they are currently working on it. Now, for this one right here, I do recommend 2v2, simply because that 2v2 gives out more war points, okay? Now, we're going to be discussing the war points, and as you guys can see right here, ta-da! Okay, now there are plenty of boxes right here. Depending on your league, some of the boxes are locked, depending on the league. But if you have Legendary League, you will have all the boxes unlocked. Now keep in mind, if you have yet to watch my Developer's Diary review, there will be another box here, separately, separate box right here for the Diamond League. Okay, or whatever you call it. Star League, yeah. Star League, yeah. Okay, now, my tip here is for you to go to versus 2 with your clanmate, okay? Now, by default, if you go with someone else, you will earn 230 war points, and going with a clanmate gives you additional 50 war points. Now, guys, now if you were to start with one box right here, you play 3 times, and you may end up doing, or you know, like 1120 war points, given that you also finished some of your contracts. Okay, so contracts right here, and as you guys can see, contracts, you may actually, now if you're not going to do PvP, because I mentioned that you're going to go 2v2, you may just watch an ad for it, okay, and then just go for the 2v2, because 2v2 gives out more war points for you to save time and gain more war points. Okay, now going back over to the war points right here, as you guys can see, these are very, very good. And as you guys can see also, you can actually open those and look at the difference between each boxes right here. Now if you go over here, you may have 7,000 to 7,800, and you go over this box right here, you get up to 11,000 credits, and you go over here up to 15.3k credits, and the difference are not really that much. Okay, that's like 2,300 only. Okay, now you can actually open this within 2 days or less. Okay, now if you also go with your partner or clanmate for AI, you may also gain like 50% of this, like 240 war points. So that's not entirely bad. Now, why I mentioned 2v2 and skirmish before, you know, like, then PvP? That is because PvP only gives you 115 war points, okay? That's low, okay? Now, for a tournament, this is also very good. 345 war points if you win the tournament. Now, if you lose in 10 minutes, you may still earn war points, but of course, let's not talk about losses. We're going to talk about winning. Okay, so yeah, if you win, 345, and if you lose, this is pretty much it. Okay, now for beginners out there, you may be wondering why I'm not, you know, why I'm not mentioning this, because this is too low. But of course, for beginners, you may try and do this, because this is very, very easy for beginners. As you try and open a game, and with a new account, you can actually do this quest right here, and this can actually give you war points as well as credit, like a small rebate for your upgrade cost. Okay, so kind of like a discount or so. Now for contracts, they do differ daily, given that you finished all contracts on a daily basis. But if not, the contracts will remain the same with the same progress. Okay, now I do have 4 out of 5 right here. Now guys, if you do contract 5 times a day, then basically you can open this box right here, which gives you an additional 7.4k credits. So how much credits do we have now? Okay, so yeah, I mean, if you count, like if I do 3 times 2v2 and win all of it, like that's like a clean 30k for AI or skirmish. So that's like a total of 60,000 credits. Plus you do add up the small rewards right here. Now they may be small, but if you add them up, that's a total of like what? 3k credits. Okay, and then add the 7.4 credits. 7.4k credits, so that's like a total of 80k credits in just a single day. Okay, and that does not include if you go tournament. Okay, now you may choose to go 3 times tournament if you are, you know, like running for a tournament rank or so. But yeah, tournament is also good for farming credits as well as war points, guys. Now, as for the contract boxes right here, it does have a guarantee of 100%, 100% gold, and so on. Okay, now this include boost, tokens, reroll cards, skip cards, skill cards. No, skip cards and skill cards are, you know, the best that you can get for contract boxes. Okay, the more you do this on a daily basis, it may actually drop skill cards that can actually help you increase your skill for free, of course. Okay, now next thing we have here is the command support. You know, this is, you know, add boxes. All right, so just to let you guys know, now for this blue one right here, you may choose to watch a like a bonus reward. Okay, now this also applies for supplies, your personal war point boxes. You need to watch the daily, or no, not the daily, you need to watch the ad bonus. Now for me personally, I do watch ads for the credits if it's more than 1000 credits. Okay, by watching it, I gain like 1000 plus credits, then I'll watch it. If not, if any lower than that, I will not waste time. Okay, just to let you guys know. Now again, clan boxes. Now guys, I keep mentioning on my previous videos that you need to be on a good or a very good clan. Okay, a very good clan, I mean, is that the players are very active. Okay, what does that mean? Players that are very active tend to have more war points due to the members in the clan or members of the clan playing actively by themselves, or, you know, like playing 2v2 with the clanmate, then they earn war points. Now the accumulated war points can lead you to open the boxes right here, and as you guys can see, I am at Frigabore right now, and we have this box right here, and we are so close to opening this 807,000 war point clan box right here, which gives me a set of up to 31k and of course additional rewards. As you guys can see right here, the boxes may also contain this much reward right here. Okay, most of the time it's skip cards, tokens, and skill cards. All right, just to let you guys know, and of course some boost. You may also choose to reroll it if you don't wish it, but I choose to reroll if the box is above 10. Okay, same thing goes here. I do reroll the rewards if the box is right around here. I will reroll it if I don't like the reward. Okay, so basically what have we have now? We do have World War. Okay, World War is definitely, I mean, it does have a bonus, but it's not really that much. Now say for example you get domination points by doing PvP, then, or 2v2, then yeah, you will earn domination points, as we call it right here, and you may get income or credits, gold, if your faction wins. Okay, now just to let you guys know, the Confederation is holding still, and if the resistance could not overtake 50%, then the resistance will lose, Confederation will win, and if I do have like around 20,000 domination points right here, then I may actually earn like 5,000 credits or so. Okay, now guys, we do have another factor for the clan again. The clan influence. Now what does this do? What is clan influence? Okay, now clan influence do give you additional reward. Okay, more share. Okay, now say for example my clan doesn't have it because the, you know, World War turn ended. Now guys, if your clan has like around 1 million credit, okay, that's not impossible. I mean, it's pretty, you know, like pretty much common at high ranks. If your clan has 1 million war points and say for example you have 20% clan influence, then basically you can have like 200,000 credits out of that 1 million from your clan treasury. Okay, and that's each week. Okay, each week. Now how do you get how do you increase your influence, clan influence? Basically just play. Okay, the more you win, the more stars you gain, then basically you can have more clan influence. Okay, so say for example you have 10%, you get 100,000 off of that. But not only that guys, say for example your clan won a tournament number one, then basically you have gold,
And then you also get the share of that gold, 20%, 10%, depending on your clan influence. Again, okay, again, let me just rephrase this. Let me just reinstate this or emphasize this, because this, you know, some players are not using the clan influence to their advantage, okay? They're too afraid to rank up and so on and so forth, then complain, pay to win. Okay, again, grinding takes time, okay? You need to play smart. That's it, okay? It takes time, takes hours, takes days, takes months, takes years. Okay, that's grinding, okay? Now, you earn stars, you get more clan influence, you get more clan share, or clan bonus reward, or clan distribution reward, okay? So, what else? The clan status. Okay, this is very important. Now, previously, when I was at EBSG Resistance, I get up to 20% clan status reward or bonus reward on each of my, you know, each of my activity like PvP tournament and so skirmish. So I do get like around 20% bonus for this. Okay, 20% bonus. Current status is trainee, gives me plus 6% bonus reward for PvP battle. Same thing goes to expert, but plus 8. Now the clan status will increase over time as you stay with your clan and earn the stars that is needed. Okay, so basically the more you play, the higher stars you will get, then you will fill up the requirement here. Okay, now in order for me to reach the expert, I need to have 150 stars and stay in the clan for over 30 days. So easy as that. You don't really have to do anything else. Just gain the stars. That's it. Basic, right? So what have we missed? Daily rewards. Yeah, daily rewards. Okay. Yeah, this one is good. This one is quite recent. Okay, you may actually good or earn some credits here. Okay, 7,000 skill cards, tokens. Now, guys, for me personally, I do watch the double reward. Okay, don't be lazy. It's just 30 seconds or less. Okay, watch the daily, the double reward for each, and then you may open this as you just, you know, open your application Art of War each day, then you can register here. Okay, quite easy, right? Very, very easy. So yeah, basically that's it, guys. That's it. That's all I have to share. And with all that we mentioned right here, now let me just point this out. Okay, 30,000 for the PvP and 30,000 for the skirmish. That's like a total of 60k. Now again, don't use boost on skirmish or AI unless you're going for a top 50, top 10, or a medal. Okay, so don't use a boost unless you're going for those reasons. So yeah, again, that's gonna be all for today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Now, oh, by the way, do not forget to buy a premium. Okay, just buy a premium. I do recommend 30 days, guys. Okay, 30 days, because you can actually save gold or more than 1,045 gold or 1,100 gold before the 30 days is over. Like more like 2 weeks or 3 weeks. Okay, you can have 1,000 plus gold to buy the premium. Okay, the premium gives you percentage to increase your reward. Okay, so here it is. It gives you additional reward, guys. Okay, so I would not like you to miss it. Plus, it gives you the ability to see your opponent. Quite neat, right? So yeah, that's gonna be all for today, folks. Again, thank you so much for tuning in and have yourself a great day. And of course, leave a comment down below as to what are your thoughts into this video and leave a suggestion on what guide video would you like me to go over next. Likewise, thank you for watching. Have a great day and good luck with your battles. Bye now.